it's Amanda. And a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is that they're so easy for the holidays. They're warm and flavorful. It's always a crowd pleaser. When I put down a nugget tray, everyone is happy.
Hey, this is
All right, welcome back here on Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Tom Callahan here with you. We finished up the warm-up portion of the program, and I realized we had some audio issues. Hopefully those are fixed, and we went right after those. Thank you very much, everybody who let us know. We appreciate it, and thanks for being there. Appreciate you along the YouTube side, along the radio side, and no matter how you're checking out Columbus River Dragons Hockey, we appreciate you being a part of things here this evening. Now, I do want to remind everybody that while tonight is the mascot birthday party and tomorrow night is the fifth anniversary, and both of those against the Mississippi Seawolves, both of those are games you definitely want to see. However, my favorite game of the year, December 16th, teddy bear toss, ugly sweater night. I think it's also scout night that night. There's a couple other things we have going on, but boy, oh boy, if you've never experienced a teddy bear toss in person, you want to be here December 16th. Mark your calendars. When the first goal is scored, here's how it works. When the first goal of the game is scored, you take those plush animals that you brought in, your new unwrapped plush animals. Some people put them in plastic bags, which does help us because it keeps the bears dry. Also makes them easier to throw. When the first goal is scored, throw the bears. All the bears hit the ice, and we stop the game, pick the bears up, and then the River Dragons, along with some area partners, will distribute those stuffed animals to children and organizations locally in need. We appreciate you coming down to the game, being a part of that, and helping us out as well. It makes a difference, and it's a difference that lasts well beyond the Christmas season. So if you do bring a bear, you bring as many bears as you want, any size, big ones, small ones, doesn't matter. I've seen life-size bears that take some effort, but eventually get over the glass. But when that first goal is scored, the bears rain down. It's a fantastic time. The River Dragons will be wearing ugly sweaters that night, and they will be raffled off following the game, and the proceeds are going to the Shrine Club of Columbus and the great work that they do, their Shrine Club, the hospital for children. And so that will also be another awesome part of the evening. The sweaters look pretty cool. If you haven't seen them yet, they really do look pretty darn good. And the other reason I bring this whole thing up is because that's our next family four-pack night. The Chick-fil-A Midland Kissin 99.3 family four-pack includes four tickets to a River Dragons game. Specifically, that would be December 16th. Four hot dogs, four popcorn, four Pepsi products, and four coupons for free Chick-fil-A sandwiches. Now, four tickets alone is more than $40. That's over $100 in value, just $40. Take advantage of this great deal. It's only sold through the River Dragons front office. So you have to come down to the Civic Center either during normal business hours, 9 to 5, Monday to Friday. We're on the west side of the building. Or you can give us a call, 706-507-4625. 706-507-4625. And purchase your Chick-fil-A Midland Kissin 99.3 family four-pack, brought to you by also Buffalo Rock Pepsi, Brewster's Ice Cream, and the Columbus Civic Center. And that's our next family four-pack night, December 16th. We also have January 13th, Hockey's for Everyone, February 10th, Youth Hockey Night, March 16th, Faith and Family Night, and April 13th, which is Fan Appreciation Night. Okay, I think we've got you all caught up there, and now it's time to take a look at our Zelmo's Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard. And tonight in the FPHL, there's five games going on, as there typically is on a weekend night, and that means all but one team in the league in action. So let's see, getting underway already. We've got Watertown and Elmira tied at one about halfway through the first period. The Motor City Rockers up to a 1-0 lead at McMorran Arena against the Port Huron Prowlers. At the bottom of the hour, it's going to be the Binghamton Black Bears at the Carolina Thunderbirds. That should be a really good hockey game. And the Blue Ridge Bobcats tonight are at the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Meanwhile, in the National Hockey League, generally not too busy on a Friday night, and three games going on in the NHL right now. The Columbus Blue Jackets with a 1-0 lead over the St. Louis Blues. Marchenko with his ninth in that one. Penguins Panthers are scoreless, just underway in the first period there. Then at 9 o'clock Eastern time, the Minnesota Wild taking on the Edmonton Oilers. How about both the Wild and the Oilers right now? Two teams suddenly headed in the right direction. The Oilers are trying to win six in a row. The Wild just suffered their first loss since the coaching change over to John Hines. Both those teams have been heating up, even though their records are still sub 500. They both had such bad starts to the year. I mean, the Oilers are at 10-12-1. The Wild at 9-11-4. They got off to such, terrible starts. But they made some changes. Both teams have made coaching changes, trying to get things going in the right direction. And Stuart Skinner for the Oilers, kind of playing out of his mind right now. It's a very good fantasy pickup. I'll go ahead and pat myself on the back for that one. But both teams have turned it around, and they're trying to get back into the thick of playoff contention. It's better to make those moves now and try to find yourself some space, and I think that's exactly what these teams have done here. So right now the River Dragons and the Sea Wolves coming up just about 14-ish minutes from now, but that's our Zelmo Zippin' out-of-town scoreboard. And taking a look at what else is going on. Oh, before we get to that, I do want to mention to you to get your free digital program for every home game available at rdragons.com, and that River Dragons Hockey is brought to you by Country Inn & Suites, the official host hotel of the Columbus River Dragons. Pepsi, the official soft drink of the River Dragons. Zelmo Zippin is the official fuel provider of the River Dragons. And Air Force Heating and Cooling, the official heating and air company of the River Dragons. And they do sponsor this pregame show. And we ask that, of course, you support those who support us. We very much appreciate your support of Columbus River Dragons hockey and hope that you do indeed support our sponsors. Without them, without you fans, it wouldn't be possible that we would be here talking about, boy, what's going to be a fantastic matchup tonight. And the crux of it is for the River Dragons, and we'll touch on this, I know Coach Bisharp will touch on this when we talk to him, but the River Dragons coming into this one against this Seawolves team want nothing more than to be defensively responsible, to be smart, to play a game that does not let them basically get caught in a tit for tat with this Seawolves team, because that can, number one, very easily happen. But number two, the Seawolves are fast, but they also take a lot of penalties. And as a matter of fact, here, this stat blew my mind when I looked it up earlier today. The Mississippi Seawolves have been shorthanded 100 times in 14 games so far this year. The next closest team to them, 68. That's unbelievable. There is a 32 power play gap between the Seawolves, and there are a bunch of teams sprinkled in the 60s, but 68 is the next closest. 32 power plays in 14 games. That's almost three a game. It's nuts to imagine that they give up 2.5 to 3 more power plays a game than any other team in the league. And with the River Dragons coming in with their power play looking a little bit better, they went 3-for-7 in their last game out against the Bobcats. Columbus is at 22.9% on the year. The downside is for the River Dragons, they are by far the least awarded team as far as power plays go in the league. They have 35 power plays. The next closest is Watertown, who have only played 11 games. Columbus has played 12. They have 43. Then it jumps up into the 50s after that. So, you know, the River Dragons certainly would like to earn more power plays here as things go along. Interestingly enough, Mississippi's only drawn 59. But, boy, that's crazy. 100 times shorthanded this year. And their penalty kill at 77% is in the bottom half of the league. So that could be, and I will go ahead and say will be, what could be the biggest difference maker in this game, could be the special teams battle, is if the River Dragons don't get into a run and gun matchup, don't fall victim to the Seawolves, stretch passes and trying to throw the bombs and make sure that they are defensively responsible, but also don't cough the puck up. Because the Seawolves team comes in bragging the top two scorers in the league. Yanni Lyriakos, the former River Dragon, leads this team, or leads the league, I should say, in scoring coming into the game here tonight, and in assists. He has 31 points, 21 of those are assists. Joaquin Nilsson, his teammate, 14 goals on the year. That's two more than Brendan Stanko and Gus Ford in Carolina. And Lyriakos also 2.4 points per game. That is number one in the entire league. The other thing is, for as often as Mississippi's been shorthanded, Jackson Bond already has three shorthanded goals on the year. And that is the most in the FPHL as well. So just a little something for the River Dragons maybe to keep in the back of the old mind as we're getting a little bit closer here to dropping the puck against the Seawolves. It's time for us to take another break here in our Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. When we come back, we're going to hear from head coach Jerome Boom Boom Bishar. Stay tuned. There's more coming your way in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Let Shred Away, a division of the Overby Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shred Away, a division of the Overby Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shred Away, 706-577-9668.
It's the fifth anniversary season of Columbus River Dragons hockey, and RiverDragonsMerch.com has everything you need, including our new limited edition anniversary look. Our DragonsMerch.com has something for all ages, with a variety of hats, shirts, jackets, and more. Plus, cool souvenir items like the always popular fan chains, pucks, and keychains. Want to order a gift for someone? We'll ship it for you. Just go online to RDragonsMerch.com. Hey sports fans, it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. Air Force Heating and Air, the official AC sponsor of the Columbus River Dragons, is excited to offer you our special $79 tune-up. Call us today at 706-661-7242 or visit us at airforceheatingandair.com. That's airforceheatingandair.com. We're always here when you need us. Air Force Heating and Air. License number PC000-4272, EC0101216.
We know that juicy, cheesy, grilled to perfection burger sounds amazing, but it does sound like something is missing. Pepsi, baby! The yin to this burger's yang. Burgers and Pepsi go together like, well, like burgers and Pepsi. This perfect blending of flavors makes every bite of lettuce, every sesame seed on the bun, and every sip of that crisp, refreshing, ice-cold cola a journey to Foodtopia. Burgers, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Welcome back to the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We're joined by head coach Jerome Bishard. And Boomer, it's party with the River Dragons all weekend long. We got mascot birthday bash tonight, fifth anniversary tomorrow. It's a lot going on. The River Dragons are off to a pretty good start. So I want to ask you, look back a little bit here over the first, 10, 12 games and give us your thoughts.
Well, obviously, good start. We're record-wise, we're 9-1-2, so got to be happy with that. And I'll be honest with you, I don't think we've played to our full potential yet. So I guess that's a positive message going in tonight. Is it was just that, guys. We've played well. We've won some games, and we haven't played a full 60 minutes yet of good Columbus River Dragon hockey. We've played 20 minutes and we fell asleep for 10 or 15 and let people back in and, you know, making, you know, kind of some bad plays to let people back in. So, you know, challenge the guys to play a full 60 minutes and keep going.
You know, but I feel like when we talk, whether it's on the radio show or in these interviews, sometimes it's not so much the physical, but the mental part of the game.
It really is. And I mean, I don't know. It's I don't know if it's a mental block or, you know, it just, I think it's mostly typical stuff where, you know what, guys trying to do too much on their own. Hockey's all about timing, you know, scoring a big goal at the right time, you know, making a great defensive play at the right time, a big save at the right time, you know, just all that stuff. And like, guys, we need a big play, and we need a big play at the right time, not all day long. I don't need guys to make unbelievable highlight reel goals and this and that. I only need one, about once in a blue moon type thing. And let's just play consistent, making sure that everybody knows what's going on all the time. As soon as that guy does that unbelievable play in our defensive zone, and I say defense or unbelievable play in the defensive zone, probably is, I guess what I'm looking at is more of a on a breakout or something like that, like a block shot, great, whatever. But on a breakout, that defenseman making an unbelievable play to beat one or two guys, that kind of puts everything out of sync a little bit, and we just got to stay in sync.
And then tonight, Mississippi coming in, a team that does everything in its power to try to get you out of sync. They try to stretch your D, they try to play run and gun.
Yeah. Not the easiest team to play against. You'd like to think they are, but they're never, you know, where they're supposed to be. You got, whether it's a one or two or three guy forechecking, you know, they just come from all areas with no rhyme or reason, and they're really tough to play against. And they got guys to put the puck on that. You know, Yanni and Liriakos and the Nilsson kid, I think they're leading the league, and you know, they're near the bottom of the league as far as standing wise, but they're leading the league in scoring. So you know what, they score a lot of goals and they give up a lot of goals. So you know, I mean, we just gotta you know, bear down on our end and bear down in the offensive zone.
That's a pretty good lead in for keys to the game there.
Keys to the game, I think, obviously Friday night we need to jump on them early. I think they're just coming in for the game tonight, so it's a nice 4.5 hour drive. You know, keep them on the bus, get a good forecheck, get ourselves going in the game. We need to be somewhat disciplined as far as penalty. They got a good power play. They're going to run around and try to get us off our game. So we need to be disciplined on that part. But physical, no turnovers, score.
All right. Boomer, thanks for joining us. Best of luck out there.
Thanks, Tom.
Back with the drop of the puck in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
We need to be somewhat disciplined. As far as penalty, they got a good power play.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat press lettering and numbering. We provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
For Beam, community isn't just a place. It's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964. Not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Hey, it's Amanda, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is that they're so easy for the holidays. They're warm and flavorful. It's always the crowd pleaser. When I put down a nugget tray, everyone is happy.
Hey, this is Brian, and the little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A nugget trays is the joy that it brings to me and everybody around me during the holidays. They're warm, juicy, and delicious.
Cater the holidays with Chick-fil-A today. Available on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests pay for their testimonials.
It's time to drop the puck. Columbus River Dragons hockey is brought to you in part by Chick-fil-A Midland, Buffalo Rock Pepsi, Tim Hortons, Columbus Diagnostic, Shredaway, The Overby Company, Vector Ply, Trivioli's, The Jersey Shop, Beam TV, WYBU Christian Television Network, Troy University, Largeman Dental, BKI Accounting, The Optical Shop, Piggly Wiggly, Sun South John Deere, Wade Cleaners, Houston Clinic, Abercrombie Bonding, First Franklin Financial, and Old School Barbershop. Now it's time for the Chick-fil-A Midland first period. Here's Tom Callahan.
And we are just getting our starting lineups introduced down on the ice. Tom Callahan here with you as we are getting ready to go for this Chick-fil-A Midland first period. Thank you so much for joining us as the River Dragons in red tonight, celebrating the mascot birthday bash here this evening. Tomorrow night's the fifth anniversary party. so it should be an awful lot of fun. Looking forward to it. We're going to have a great time here this weekend. We want you to be part of it. Come on down and join us here. It's still time. If you're looking for something to do tonight, hey, why not stop by the Columbus Civic Center and be a part of a lot of fun. Family fun and excitement here for River Dragons hockey. We absolutely love having folks come down and join us for the game. So the River Dragons finishing up the introductions here right now, and then we're going to get underway. River Dragons and the Seawolves tonight. And for the River Dragons, coming into this evening, 9-1-2, tied for tops in the Continental Division. And in third place, the Seawolves at 6-6-1-1-0, 21 points, so that 8-point gap from first to third. And right now, we're going to send it down to the ice here. We have a moment of silence, and then tonight's presentation of the national anthem. All right, so we are anthem in the books and ready to go before tonight's game here. The River Dragons will take on the Mississippi Seawolves. So let's take a look at tonight's starting goaltenders for the River Dragons. It's going to be Brendan Colgan, 4-1-1 on the year with an 894 save percentage and a 2.80 goals against average. He's opposed by Anthony D'Aloisio, who is making his first start of the season, so no numbers, no record for D'Aloisio. And maybe he is the answer for the Seawolves to try to turn things around a little bit here on the defensive side. But as we've talked about before, this is a Seawolves team, if you will, that it's live by the sword, die by the sword. These guys, they play a run and gun, highly offensive style of hockey, and that's just what they do, what they're going to go after. And you know what you're going to get when it comes to this Mississippi Seawolves team. You also know what you're not going to get, which is not a lot of defense. I mean, they're head manning every puck. Guys are always blowing the zone, which means they're taking off as soon as they see even the potential sometimes for a turnover. Sometimes the turnover is not even made, and they're still leaving. So that is something the River Dragons have to be very aware of, because if you get caught, it means behind you, there could be a 2-on-1, there could be a breakaway, it could be a 2-on-0. And you don't want to hang your goaltender out to dry. Now, the flip side of that, of course, is that for the River Dragons, it means you have to be alert, you have to communicate, you have to give up the defensive zone sometimes, or the offensive zone when you don't want to. but they also must be alert. If that defenseman, say, on the left side, backs onto the zone, has to make a coverage play in the neutral zone, the forwards have to know that. If they wanted to pass it around to that player at the point and that player's not there, well, guess what? You need to be alert. And so that is also something I think this River Dragons hockey team has to be very aware of as they're getting ready to go here tonight. All right, so for the River Dragons, a couple of players coming in on some hot streaks here. And it looks like they are going to keep the lines that they've had going the last little bit together. And again, the band back together. It's Doe, Petrantonio, Bersani up front to start it off. That line that was so successful for the River Dragons a couple of years ago. Back together is Hunter Bersani back with the team. And the Seawolves will dump it in, but they are way in offside. And the River Dragons end up taking the whistle there, so just 17 seconds in, we get our first offside call of the game. That offside brought to you by Old School Barber Shop. They're online at Old School Barber, shoppe.com. If your sides are a little off, book your next appointment online anytime. Old School Barber Shop. River Dragons trying to chip it ahead into the neutral zone. Puck hits a body. Bersani fighting for it. He'll flip it in off the dasher. Bush Anderson around after it. He'll look on the near side. Bush Anderson off the glass. Down it goes. Underwood chasing. That'll be icing. 36 seconds in. We've already got our second whistle of the game. So we're here tonight and tomorrow night against the Seawolves. Tomorrow night's a 7:05 puck drop. And that is our fifth anniversary party. Don't forget post-game party at the Loft, 21 and over. You get a chance to meet your River Dragons there and celebrate the fifth anniversary season, the debut of the teal home fifth anniversary jerseys. The River Dragons just wearing them on special occasions this year. Tomorrow night will be the first time at home. Moore will dump it in. D'Aloisio trying to knock it down. Puck into the left side corner. Swung around towards the right point. Shinkarik keeping it in, but only momentarily as Wong tried to move it ahead, but he fanned on that pass. That allows McDonald to recover and feed it back. Moore pressured by Wong. Loops behind his own net, and now the River Dragons attack through center. Wong left side in over the line to the dot. Stick handling. Checked off his stick. Helland will leave it back behind the net, and Seawolves regroup. We'll try a long stretch off the glass, off the skate of Shinkarik. Turn back the other way, so Seawolves must regroup again. There's another stretch through center, deflected away. River Dragons on it. Columbus moving in right side. Hunter weaving in the slot, try to feed it through. It was blocked on the way. And they jam away at it. McDonald swats it out to center, back towards his defenders. And now Slahetka will move it right back in. Slahetka stick handling through some traffic, leaves it on. Storjahan with a long shot right into the chest protector. D'Aloisio holding on. And the faceoff will come to his right. Brennan Colgan in net, patrolling for the River Dragons. River Dragons on the right side. Here's Wickline. Trying to move it around. Storjahan to the left side. Onto the near wing off the boot of King. And out it goes through center. Puck at center. River Dragons controlling. Here's King. Moving it ahead. And turn back the other way. Liracos tipping it down. Colgan will paddle it aside. King asks for check pressure. Gets it ahead. Takes a bump for his efforts. Pass through center. Did not connect. Wickline up looking for it. Bersani out there trying to be pesky on the forecheck as Wickline now heads to the bench. Bush Anderson on the left wing. And that play, well, they say it was onside. Boy, it didn't look like it. But Seawolves get a nice chance out of it as well. Now the River Dragons break back the other way up the left wing side. Petrantonio looking for Doe one time! And making the save there, getting over to his left somehow was D'Aloisio. Another shot coming in. D'Aloisio, the glove save. But boy, Doe had it on a tee on the near side. Great pass from Petrantonio. And the Seawolves goaltender able to get to his left to make the save. Now the River Dragons trying to put it up top. Cleared off the dasher and out to center. Petrantonio takes a bump there and it ends up back with Underwood. Underwood at center. He'll get to the stripe, dump it in. Love down, and Aloisio flips one high in the air, just gets it out of there. Bounces past Bockwell all the way down the ice. 3.5 gone here in the first. No score. We appreciate you tuning us in on the River Dragons flagship station, 106.9 Really Rocks, and along our YouTube feed. River Dragons in for a shot, ripped high on the blocker side. Around to the right point, it goes McDonald, a backhand, keeping it in. Lind behind his own net. Past Wong on a bank out to center. And here come the Seawolves, left side moving in with a shot. Colgan save, ooh, rebound away, but Gill able to move that one away. Kuznetsov had a good chance there. Back comes Moore in, looking to center, pass blocked by traffic. Fed back towards the line, Shinkarik able to keep it in. Oh no, they say that was offside. So the whistle goes, crowd didn't like it. 4:09 into the first, that offside brought to you by Old School Barbershop. Need to get lined up? Check out Old School Barbershop online at oldschoolbarbershoppe.com. You can also book your next appointment online anytime through their Instagram and their Facebook page. McDonald in for the draw. Cross from Anderson. McDonald wins it back right to Gill, who will chip it into the left side corner. Here's Swan in after it. He'll finish his hit. And it's played out to center. McDonald on it, turning it back, looking for Swan. Swan up on the forecheck here. And now, ooh, a little miscommunication with the goaltender. Almost resulted in a turnover, but puck out of the zone. It's one of the things when you get a new goalie out there, Swan tips that puck in. Sometimes it can be a little bit dangerous when they come out to play it, is the icing coming up here against the River Dragons. We saw last weekend in Blue Ridge, Taylor Joseph, who's newer here, still played a few games with the River Dragons, but also a tighter area behind the net. And a couple of times the handoffs were botched, ended up in the back of the River Dragons net. Two just directly on giveaways, and that's why the communication is so important. River Dragons maintain the puck. There's a quick chance in front. Storjahan didn't get a full piece of it. Oh my, quick feed in front, and looked like Storjahan kind of towed it as he went to go lean into it. Daloisio was right there to make the save and cover. Faceoff coming up to the right of the Seawolves net. River Dragons keep it in. Storjahan, quick shot, and that one finds the netting. Out of play it goes. Didn't hear the whistle, but everybody stopped, and so we'll just face it off again to the right of Daloisio. Storjahan in the faceoff circle. And it's one back by Mississippi, but they fail to clear the zone. Jemayev steals it away. Jemayev into the right side corner. River Dragons trying to move it around. Up towards the point. King pushes and can't keep it in. Now it's 3-on-1. But nice job there by Slahetka to get the stick in the way of the pass. He broke it up. Boy, that's the only thing that saved the River Dragons from real peril. Here's Liorakos in behind the play. Colgan way out to play it in the corner. Scoops it up towards the right point. Bush Anderson holding it in. Slahetka, clear hit, Bush Anderson. Now it's out. Wickline, right side moving ahead, trying to flip it into space. Jemayev following up the play. Checked by Lynn, still has it. Tried to wiggle it free, threw it to the crease. Puck ends up behind the net. Jemayev over to the far side corner. To the left point. Captain Bockwell tipped by Wickline. Save made and covered. And that'll get us to our first break. We'll be right back with more in a moment. Scoreless here. 5:50 into the first period. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey. Play checked by.